Greetings, beautiful people. This is SB Favor Thinking Podcast, and my name is SB Favor. It is Tuesday, October 27th, 2020. It is another wonderful day, another day to keep it moving, another day to be thankful. As I always say, we all have something to be thankful for, so be thankful. I do have a quote for you today, and my quote states, "The benefits to stay inspired is better than a downward spirit that has no benefits at all. You can choose. So stay inspired today." There are so many benefits from staying inspired and simply just being motivated. When we get up in the morning, we get to choose what type of mindset we're going to have. We get to choose what type of day we're going to have. And yes, sometimes we get up in the morning and some of us, we may have different things going on in our lives. And, you know, you get up in the morning and sometimes it might be tough, but you get to decide what type of day you are going to have. So when you get up in the morning, you think to yourself, and ask yourself the question, what type of day do I want to have? Your day should not be based upon what is happening, good or bad. Your day has to be based upon you making a decision to have a good day. So first things first, when you get up in the morning, most of us, we do pray. And those of us that don't, I hope that you will start to pray. But like I said, first things first, when you get up in the morning, you pray. And then after you pray, you make a decision that you are going to have a good day. And then as you go forward into your day, keep the right thoughts. There are many ways that you can stay inspired. I'm going to give you a few tips about that. I have 5 tips that can help you to understand the benefits that you can receive when you stay inspired. Number one, if you stay inspired, you can manage your stress. Because if you don't manage your stress, stress can affect your body. Stress can cause headaches, fatigue, mood swings, stomach aches. Who wants to have that? So stay inspired so that you can manage your stress. Number two, when you stay inspired, you can keep a clear and peaceful mind. For those of us that believe in Jesus, Jesus said, if you keep your mind stayed on me, I'll give you perfect peace. So guess what? You can stay inspired just by thinking about Jesus. And if you don't know Jesus, well, you know what I'm going to say about that? Then you need some Jesus, because Jesus can give you some peace. Number three, you can become an asset to others when you stay inspired. How? Because when someone else is in your presence and they have a need to be inspired, you have an opportunity to inspire them. Number four, your attitudes can stay in a healthy place to filter out the wrong thoughts when you stay inspired. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. When you are inspired and you have made a decision to have a good day, and when you are focused on the good things and you are determined to have a good day, you will filter out the wrong thoughts. You can keep your thoughts in a good place, in a happy place, in a peaceful place to surpass everything that's going on in your life. You don't have to have a day based upon what is happening, good or bad. You can decide what type of day you want to have. Number five, when you stay inspired, you become equipped to meet the needs of others constantly, because you are filled with courage to encourage others. So stay inspired. It does not benefit us at all to just walk around being moody and with the doom and gloom. It does not benefit us. All that is going on right now, as I stated yesterday in my podcast, this time that we're living in, it is an opportunity to learn something about God that we have never learned before. So stay inspired. And when I mention God, for those of you that are scared of the word God, because when you hear God, you start thinking, oh, there they go. She's talking religious. No. When I talk about God, I'm talking about life. When I talk about God, I'm talking about peace. When I talk about God, I'm talking about absolute joy, because that's who and what he is. So stay inspired today. Lift yourself up. Surround yourself with good people. We got to keep it moving. We have to continue to stay on course to keep all things good. And I know sometimes that might seem impossible, but guess what? It's possible. If we pray, if we encourage one another, if we do all that we know to do, we can stay inspired. I know somebody out there might be asking the question, well, do SB, do she ever get discouraged? Guess what? Guess what? I have challenging days just like everybody else. But in my challenging days, you know what I do? I decide to get up. If I get up on one leg, I push until I get up on two legs. Oh, yes. I keep pushing until I get up. And then, of course, I have an army of people that are always praying for me, that are always encouraging me. So, yes, I have challenging days, but I get up. So that's why I'm telling you to stay on course. Keep praying. Keep projecting what is good. Keep your mind on the things that are good. Keep your spirit lifted. We got to get through all these crazy things that are going on in our country. We don't have to reflect bad news. We can still have peace. We can still have joy. And we can still keep what is good in our life. So that is my quote for today. I thank you so much for listening to SB Favorite Thinking Podcast. I want to remind you again to go out and vote if you have not already voted. This is the last week, and next Tuesday, November 3rd, is the final day to vote. So if you have not already voted, please go out there and vote. You must. We are in a serious time. If you are one of those people that are just sitting around saying to yourself, oh, I don't want to vote, you know, my vote doesn't count. Guess what? You have the wrong view about what voting is. I think you need to do some homework and do some research so that you can understand your civic duty. We all are in this together, and we have to vote so that we can bring a change to our country. So go out there and vote. I want to also remind you that it is still October, the last week of October, and it is still Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So if you have not already donated to a cause, donate to a cause. And for those of you that need to be reminded, women, get your examinations done, and let's keep a tab on these things so that we can just do better. Have an awareness and keep ourselves in check. Another thing, later today, I will be doing a podcast with Rebecca, and we will be talking about sacrifice and selfishness. Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed. The word selfish is, when you mention that, some people get afraid because that thing has to be exposed. Being selfish has to be exposed. And all of us are guilty of being selfish to a certain extent. And we're going to also talk about sacrifice. So the benefits of sacrifice. So that's going to be a good podcast. So tune in if you can. I appreciate you listening to SB Favorite Thinking Podcast. If you need to reach me, you can reach me at sbfavor@yahoo.com via email. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I also have a YouTube channel at SB Favor. Please subscribe to my channel and you will not miss an episode of SB Favorite Thinking Podcast. I appreciate you listeners. If you would like to leave me some type of feedback, please feel free to do so. I will not respond to anything that is negative because I do not respond to negativity online. That is my rule. Okay. So on that note, I thank you again for listening to SB Favorite Thinking Podcast. Tune into my next podcast. As I stated, it's going to be a good one. You have a good day.